Are you or somebody that you know suffering from Stockholm Syndrome? Would you like to know more information? Perhaps get some help? If so, please stay tuned for more. Hey guys, how's it going and welcome back to another episode. So, before we get started, what is Stockholm Syndrome? Well, what Stockholm Syndrome pretty much is in definition is when somebody gets kidnapped, when somebody is a hostage, when somebody is in the position like that, and all of a sudden, as the hours and the days go on, that person that is kidnapped, captured under some sort of mental, physical abuse, they start sympathizing and in some cases falling in love or what have you, but just all of a sudden they get on the side of their captor. And this has happened many times in history before, but I just wanted to give a quick little description as to what that is, because that's something I mentioned at the very beginning of the episode, and that's something that we're going to be talking about today. All right, and what do I mean by that? Well, basically, as each day is going on, as we get further and further into this COVID-1984 situation that we're all living in right now, we are all starting to see slowly but surely that this whole thing was either, you know, a sham or definitely way overblown, but at the very least it's not what it seems, and a lot of people are starting to wake up, get really upset, and you know, for lack of a better description, push back. You know, just push back and demanding their freedoms and in the extreme cases in which they're very, very much being taken away. And so right now we're experiencing a lot of stuff. Right before I even started filming, I'm looking on YouTube video after video of people all over the world, especially in the US though, pushing back and just demanding their rights back, demanding their freedom back. And again, when it's just one or two people against the authorities, it doesn't end well. But when it's crowds of people, when it's a lot of people against the authorities, all of a sudden authorities stand down and back off, because again, numbers, you know, speak louder than words. So you already know the deal. But what is a Stockholm Syndrome? Again, I keep bouncing around this. Well, as we're waking up, we're also realizing that there's a lot of people out there that are still believing this narrative. There's a lot of people out there that are gonna believe this narrative no matter what. There's a lot of people out there that are gonna just be digging in their heels even further. Whatever their agenda is, whether it's because they wanna collect a government check, because they don't wanna admit that they were wrong, or because they don't wanna admit, you know, because of a political party one way or the other, or an idealism, you know, whether it's a science, you know what I mean, whatever it is, or, you know, left or right or whatever, it doesn't matter. There's a lot of people out there, you know, we can call them NPCs, we can call them Mr. Smith, you know what I mean, just like in the Matrix, you know, call them whatever we wanna call them, but there's still a lot of these individuals out there. And unfortunately, as we go forward here, those are going to be, in a sense, you know, the most difficult actors to deal with. Not necessarily our government or, you know, people of authority or power, no, but it's these other individuals that are within our ranks that are still, you know, again, not just believing that narrative, but again, digging in their heels even further. And those are the most dangerous people out there, you know what I mean, in a sense, you know, unfortunately, because, you know, they are the ones that are going to fight their knowledge and idealisms or ideology to the death, as you are also trying to do the same thing to protect yourself, to protect your family, to feed your family, and so on and so forth. All right? And by the way, you know, the reason this is a very difficult conversation to even have is because there's so many people out there that we love and respect of all walks of life that are still believe in this narrative, okay, 100%. And we can sit here and say very easily, oh, you know, those guys are working for the government, or those guys are part of the problem or the narrative or whatever. But the reality is that we have to realize that, you know, sure, you know, there's a few, you know, actors or famous people, not actors, I'm sorry, but, you know, a few people that, again, famous people out there, whether it's Joe Rogan or whether it's, you know, name your favorite dude or dudette out there, okay? Or whether it's your mom or your grandma or your friend that you love and hold so dear. These are all individuals that could most likely be playing that, you know what I mean? That, you know, that the opposition here. You know, so, you know, right now as we're dealing with this, you know what I mean? As we're dealing with everything that we're dealing with, it's starting to resemble a lot closer to what was going on during the Civil War. All right, again, we got to remember, you know, back during the Civil War, it was a mother against daughter, father against son. You know, again, you know, it was just a war of ideals. Remember, right now, right before this whole thing happened, we were already, you know what I mean, literally, you know, on the verge of, you know, ripping each other's throats out over Thanksgiving dinner, over just the president or policies or whatever. So now imagine how much it's all been ramped up now, because now it's not even about that. It's about health, right? I know better than you and vice versa and all that. Now all these authoritarian individuals out there that were trying to push an agenda one way, guess what? Now they're even becoming even more authoritarian. Again, it, you can see it for yourself. You're not even allowed to go to the beach. You're not even allowed to go outdoors without even, you know, the popo or a Karen out there or something like that. You know what I mean? Just coming to the rescue of the community. You feel me? And so, again, you know, if we live in a free country, then we should have all the right to do whatever we want as long as we're not hurting anybody. All right? Now, when a government entity or some other, you know, godlike entity is saying that, hey, we need to stop you from doing what you're doing for the betterment of the herd, it's like, well, wait a minute, is this a free country or what? Is this a free society or what? It's not, is it? It's not. It definitely isn't. Okay? And again, we've already, you know, been well versed on everything that's going on right now, especially if you're listening to me right now. Again, here, I wrote down a bunch of notes. Let's get into it, okay? Just like a couple weeks ago when I was, we were talking about those doctors, the ones that were, you know, they were being broadcast on a mainstream media outlet, a local mainstream media outlet. These two doctors that were, you know, out there, you know, pretty much spitting out the facts. And, you know, long story short, they were basically just saying, hey, everything that we're doing is 1,000% wrong. Hey, the actual kill rate of this disease in California is like 0.03. What the hell are we doing? What is going on here? And at the same time, you know, by the way, as you're saying that, YouTube is censoring this. Again, they didn't do anything that violates any part of any YouTube, you know, algorithm or bylaw or anything. It was just straight up censorship. And again, this is a mainstream media outlet that was now being censored in a sense. But it was a small mainstream media outlet, okay? And so, of course, you know, they don't speak for Big Daddy, and they were probably reprimanded already, you know, as we know how all these things work and happen. But again, at this, what I was saying, it was that at the same time as these things are happening, we're seeing, and again, in other parts of California, like in Ventura County and other places, where they're already announcing straight up that, hey, they're, you know, they are tracking you on the phone. They know who has the COVID, and they're coming for you. They're going to come knocking on your door and drag you out of the house if they have to. Now, they weren't saying it exactly like that, but basically saying, hey, if you can't self-quarantine yourself, then we're going to self-quarantine you for you. But what I really do think is going to happen is they're going to start shuffling people away to these FEMA camps, re-education camps, whatever. Okay? Again, this is something that we've been talking about for a very long time. They've already been putting out there for a very long time. You know, the whole FEMA camp situation. You want more context on that? Do a little research. But again, you know, basically, as I want to give a little background on the FEMA camps. A lot of people don't know what that is. So, again, what are the FEMA camps? Okay, so you know, for the longest time, Walmart has been going all the way through, all through America, landing in small little towns, putting a Walmart in the small town, devastating all the small businesses, and then the Walmart is the only thing that's left. Well, there's a little bit more to that story. In a lot of cases, those Walmarts left and then devastated the city even further, because now there's no small businesses can come back online. So there's no small business, no Walmart, and now the town just becomes, you know, pure hell for the poor individuals that live there, or that remain living there, okay? That's happening all over the U.S. And now we have a bunch of abandoned Walmarts all over the U.S. Guess what? A lot of individuals out there have gone out and filmed these abandoned Walmarts. And you can see it for yourself. A lot of these have been converted into prisons, okay? Not just any prisons, maximum security prisons. And you're like, wait a minute, huh? What? Huh? Again, do the research, you'll see. So not only that, but again, we have you know, UN trucks, we got our own military, we have, you know, body bags, you know, all over the place, coffins all over the place, you know, again, you already seen what they were doing in New York. They wanted to see how the public would react. They were, nobody was even, you know, they were, again, they were already doing mass graves in New York. Again, they already have mass graves areas all around the US. They got the FEMA camps, the re-education camps, they got all that going. They have, you know, all those coffins, you know what I mean, that they need special coffins for that. There's so many, they can just do your own research. But, you know, again, going back to, you know, another video that I saw not too long ago, a couple days ago, and by the way, I wish I could put more of these videos on here, but they're just gonna knock my video off. I mean, it's enough that they let me talk, you know, but anywho. There's this video that I saw on Instagram the other day. It was just a nurse, you know, talking about the atrocities, about what's really going on. You know, she was just like, "Oh my God, I feel like I'm an employee at a Nazi internment camp, where I'm seeing these doctors and these workers of mine, these other co-workers of mine, you know, go literally killing people left and right, left and right, left and right." She was giving so many examples as to how they were dying, how they were getting killed, and they were all being labeled COVID-19 deaths. I mean, basically, and it was just crazy. It was just basically a lot of medical malpractice, a lot of medical, what's the word I'm looking for? A lot of medical, just malpractice, okay? You know, negligence. That's what I was looking for. A lot of negligence, and again, a lot of looking the other way. You know, a lot of things like, "Oh my God, this guy needs something in his lung." They put it in there, and they put it in wrong, and instead of like trying to save the guy's life, they just dig it in a little deeper, kill the guy. You know, shit like that. Or a guy with a low heartbeat, they want to fucking give him, you know, a defibrillator, you know, which is something that's, or you only do to somebody with a dead heart. You know what I mean? All of a sudden you get a shock, it's gonna stop your heart. And so on and so forth. And one thing after the other, and I'm like, "Oh my God." And so, you know, in a sense, we're already living in a communism. We're already living in Nazi Germany in so many ways, all right? And it's very, very, very insane that the United States is falling into this, okay? And in many parts of the world, it's, you know, this is happening, all right? This is not just in the US, but in other parts of the world, like in Europe and so on and so forth, you know, Argentina, whatever. It's a bunch of countries that are going through this right now. That's why when I was like you saw a couple videos ago here, when I was walking around and I got harassed by a police officer out here, it was like, what? You know, people out here were, you know, yeah, they were taken aback by that. I mean, I got a lot of you know, a video kind of like became a little bit viral out here, because again, you know what I mean, that's not something the cops do out here. And sure enough, you know, people were already acting in defiance, you know, soon after that. So so, you know, there's a lot of places where people are pushing back and acting in defiance and so on and so forth. But with that same token, you know, just like you know, that nurse was in that hospital talking about, "Oh my God, am I the only sane one in here? Why is everybody complicit? Oh my God, am I the only one that sees this? Why is everybody just complicit in just killing all these people and going through all this? Why don't?" And so, you know, the thing is, again, that's why I bring up, you know, for people out there to read things like the Gulag Archipelago and read up on Nazi Germany and read up, you know, really deep down into what happened with a lot of these things. Because again, overnight, you know what I mean? This is the transition happens. You know, basically a lot of these doctors that were, you know, doctors and nurses and a lot of these people that were working at that particular hospital and other particular hospitals, you know, that from one minute they were, you know, life-saving heroes, individuals, and now all of a sudden they're, you know, again, the same people that were working in these Nazi camps. And, you know, now let's go to the United States police officers, you know what I mean? The police officers in the United States, and again, all over the, you know, in a lot of these countries that I mentioned, you know, like in Europe and Canada and so on and so forth, where a lot of these police officers, you know, are acting like the Gestapo, you know, acting, you know, again, you know, straight up, you know, like Nazi Germany, you know, when they were just out there, you know, imposing their will on the people, you know, just doing whatever the hell they wanted. And nothing that no one could stop them. And we know this, you know, we've already talked, you know, we already talked to death, you know what I mean, about police brutality and the powers that they have, you know, absolute power corrupts, yeah, absolute power corrupts, absolutely. And that's what we're seeing with, you know, in the United States right now with, you know, the police force, you know, where we're seeing all over the U.S., you know, prisons being emptied. You know, we're seeing murderers and we're seeing, you know, high violent crime criminals and all, and you know, low violent crime and all kinds of criminals being released. You know, rapists, murders, child, you know, you know, molesters, you know, player-arounders and all that shit. All kinds of people just willy-nilly, you know, just being released because of COVID. You know, we don't want to, you know, infect them inside. You know, again, these people that have committed, you know, the most heinous crime imaginable, you know, like, again, like, you know, kid fuckers and, you know, a bunch of people out there, you know, murderers and shit like that. Oh, yeah, we want to spare them of COVID. Are you fucking kidding me right now? Are you kidding me? Anyways. So yeah, so that's happening, and at the same time, what are they doing? They're arresting you, Susan. They're arresting you, Jimmy. They're arresting Tommy and Bob and everybody else. And why are they arresting all these people? Well, because you know, Karen was out at the park. They're arresting Jimmy because he opened up his business. They're arresting you know, Tim because, you know, he wasn't wearing his mask, you know, and all that shit. And again, we were, for a millisecond, we've been sitting there and taking it, but again, now we're pushing back. And why was bringing up the Civil War situation again? Because, you know, again, right before I came on here, I was just looking at Instagram and looking at those things and stuff like that, and I saw that Ted Cruz was at the barbershop. Because, okay, by the way, so there was this barbershop in Texas that, you know, that opened up because she needed to open up, all right, because she needed to feed her kids, and they arrested her. All right, and then when they arrested her, they took her to court. And when they took her to court, in front of the judge was saying, "All right, I'll let you free. I won't let you spend any night in jail. I'm just gonna fine you, but you need to just say that you're sorry and that you're sorry for putting people in danger and that you gotta plead and you gotta beg and all this shit." And she's like, "No, I'm not gonna do any of that. No, because I'm not sorry, because I needed to feed my kids, and this is all wrong, and blah, blah, blah." So anyway, so the judge threw her in jail and the whole thing, and guess what? Went straight to Texas Supreme Court, and then they got her right out. And she's now back open for business, and Ted Cruz was out there giving her, getting a haircut, first customer to get a haircut there. And again, this isn't politics. I'm not on the left or the right or anything. I'm nowhere, but it's just to show you what's happening. You know, there's lines being starting to drawn. You know, lines are starting to get drawn all across the, you know, all across the sand, all across the U.S. right now, okay? And as we see, you know, there's a lot of cops out there, a lot of sheriffs, that are also saying, "I'm not gonna impose these horrible Nazi 1984 laws and draconian measures on the people of my community." And then there's other cops like the ones in Texas and others all over the place that are more than happy to comply and arrest people on the beach for being on the beach. Or again, like I got harassed the other day, and so on and so forth, okay? Because again, absolute power corrupts absolutely. So we're starting to see a major rift, not just in the US, but all over the world. Depending on where you are, depending on what's gonna happen. In a place like Mexico, you know, again, they got a little bit of power, but the people push back real quick because the people push back all the fucking time out here, so it's not gonna last very long. And then, yeah, yours, you already know there's other elements out here in power. It's a completely different story. But when it comes to the US, again, just like in Canada, you know, they were arresting some girl that was wearing a stormtrooper outfit on Monday for May the 4th, be with you, or whatever the fuck, some Star Wars shit. You know, they literally arrested a nerd, this girl that was crying and going through this whole fucking, you know, literally traumatic experiences she's never gonna forget again. You know, all these Canadian cops, you know, pointing the gun at her like she's like the biggest terrorist in the world. And it was just, again, a nerd bar that had a Star Wars themed day on, you know, Monday. They were advertising it the whole freaking thing. And again, you know what I mean? They go and arrest her. And I'm not gonna get into details of the story. I know there's more details to the story, just like there's more details to all these stories, but it's not the point. The point is that what has happened? Now let's go back to a little bit to, you know, the waking up of all kinds of people. I'm not gonna be able to put this on there, but if you want, you can check it out on my BitChute channel. By the way, before I keep going, let's do a little bit commercial break here, guys. Guys, please, if you wanna really make an impact and you really wanna make a change, why don't you get yourself a COVID 1984 face mask, like you see right here. That's right. You can wear this proudly, no matter what the hell you think. And if you don't want to wear a face mask like me, then guess what? Get yourself a t-shirt. Whatever. The point is that I even made some Stockholm Syndrome t-shirts. I made a bunch of shirts, a bunch of masks, a bunch of stuff, and I'm going to keep adding stuff to the store. But anyways, this is for you to make impact, okay? For you to spread the word, for you to, you know, protest without violence, okay? A non-violent protest, okay? Of your freedoms and liberties being taken away. So again, want to give a shout out to Callie for, you know, helping me, you know, push me to make these masks out there. I've already made a few sales, and I hope to make a few more. And again, I'm only making a couple bucks on these masks. It's not the point. The point is, again, I just wanted to, you know, keep, you know, adding. You know, sure, spreading my videos and all that stuff is great, but this is another way where you can, yeah, again, you know, push back and look cool doing it. All right, so also before that, you know, check out my website. So, because this channel is at risk of getting taken down for obvious reasons, like because I make a lot of videos like this, and I've been making a lot of them like this. I already have strikes, I already have all that stuff. So please, you know, check out my website so that way you know where I am at all times. You can sign up in case I disappear completely. Also, I have another channel that you can check out. So again, anything ever happens here, I'm on the other channel. I upload stuff to that channel all the time. I literally uploaded something yesterday. I'm uploading now something today for this channel, and so on and so forth. Also, on Monday, the Bitcoin halving has happened. It could be Sunday night, it could be sometime during Monday. Regardless, I'm gonna have a special super duper Bitcoin halving live stream coming up, so please check that out. And check out the podcast. A lot of people are watching and listening to that, I mean, and a lot of you guys are loving it, so check out the podcast. And yeah, that's it. Just keep checking everything out. Now, back to the show. Sorry. All right, so what I was gonna say was the fact that, you know, on my BitChute channel, all right, because I can't have it on YouTube for a lot of reasons, not only do I have the doctors talking, okay, the ones that I was talking about, the ones in California, like exposing a lot of the stuff that's happening, but the president of Tanzania, I mean, this guy was freaking genius. You know, this guy deserves a genius award for 2020. So the guy, the president of Tanzania, you know, he was presented with a bunch of coronavirus tests, a bunch of fucking COVID-19 tests to, you know, again, give to his people, you know, to check for the virus, you know, Tanzania, right? Anyways, so, you know, the guy, you know, like a lot of African nations, you know, they don't trust the white man. They don't trust, you know, the WHO, you know what I mean? The Chinese organization, you know, China's already been fucking over a bunch of guys out there in Africa. Again, another story for another day. But the point is that, so a lot of nations out there, again, if you even go to Zimbabwe and you show a dollar, they'll probably kill you, for sure. You know what I mean? So don't be going to Zimbabwe and no dollars, right? A little travel tip. But the point, anyways, but in Tanzania, you know, again, they don't trust, you know, the East, the West, they don't, the North, the South, they don't trust anybody. And with all good reason, you know, So what did the president do? Okay, so he got all these COVID tests, all these corona tests that were given to him by the WHO. And he went around and he started testing goats, dogs, papayas, mangoes, you name it. All right. And every test that he gave to a papaya or a goat, he gave it a name. So this papaya is John Smith, age 37, blah, blah, blah. You know, this goat is Karen Johnson, you know, age 20, you know, whatever. You know what I mean? Like that. You know what I mean? It just did a bunch of that. And guess what? They all basically came back positive, a good majority of them. And he, you know, put out the news like, bro, what the hell's going on here? Really? All of my whole country, the sand has fucking corona. Everything has corona. So again, you know, going back to, you know, how a lot of this stuff is being manufactured and produced, you know, a lot of this propaganda. Well, basically, again, if you look a little bit into it, they'll tell you, the CDC, the WHO, all of these individuals will tell you straight up that, you know, these tests are going to come back with an 80% or higher false positive or false, a false test or whatever. How is this even a valid test if like 80% of the tests are going to come back as false positives? Or they're going to come wrong? So, I mean, go on and on. And again, that's why I bring up the Stockholm Syndrome, because as each day goes on, every single individual out there is going to have a completely different reason for waking up. You know, some people are going to wake up hardcore the minute that they go to Wendy's or McDonald's and there's no more hamburgers. And like, hey, so when am I going to get, when are you guys going to get hamburgers? Oh, I don't know. Uh-oh. That's the problem. All right? Some individuals, it's going to be the minute that either A, they get arrested at the beach, or B, they save someone along with the crowd of people, save someone from getting arrested at the beach, at the park, so whatever. Okay? Some people, you know, we've already, you know, like me and a bunch of you guys, we've already passed that a long time ago. You know what I mean? But the point is that all of us out there are gonna have a different point in which we're gonna say, hey, enough is enough. And as this keeps, as this keeps, you know, moving along and, you know, getting worse and it keeps getting tighter, guess what? More and more people are saying enough is enough and pushing back because, again, you know what I mean? Like, I can show you a funny video of, I wish I could, but what's happening out here, where basically some lady, you know, some nasty, ugly lady was like, you know, walking at midnight, you know, through the city, and the cop was like, hey, ma'am, what are you doing? Blah, blah, blah. And the lady, started screaming at the cops, I'm gonna go get fucked. I'm about to go see my lover. How dare you bother me? Get the fuck out of here. This quarantine shit is fucking bullshit. And, you know, the only thing the cop could do, at least out here in Mexico, was film her and try to shame her, you know. Again, a very, very different story than what could happen in the U.S., but I mean, I'm just saying, people are just at enough, at their, you know, wit's end, all right? And no matter what it is, whether you want to get hanging out, you know, whether you want to go see your lover, whether you want to get your hamburger, whether you just want to sit on the beach, all right, whether you just want to take a walk, whether you just want to be left the fuck alone, whatever the fuck reason it is, people already had enough, okay? All of us, and you know, we know that, okay? And that's the thing too, you know what I mean? Like the other individuals out there that have not necessarily had enough is because they have their own agenda, you know? Either they're bootlickers, either they want the government check, either they sympathize with the government, either they sympathize with, you know, an agenda, whatever it is. And yeah, you know what I mean? As each day passes, you know, they're gonna dig in their heels even further. And man, everyone's a little different and everyone's, you know, we're all going through this at a different pace, but for sure, we're starting to see the rift. For sure, we're starting to see, you know, people really digging in their heels and picking a side. But from what I'm seeing, at least from my angle, and I think you guys as well, I'm really starting to see that there's more of us than there is of them, all right? More of us that want life to go back to normal, that want things to just, you know, we want our rights back. We want our lives back. We want just things to be normal. But now the curveball, there ain't going to be no normal. They're not. This is, I mean, there's we don't know what's going to happen after all this, because the thing is, as all this is happening, the not just the U.S. economy, definitely the U.S. economy, but the world economy is tanking. Like the heaviest anchor in the deepest ocean. Okay. That's basically what's happening. And, you know, the heaviest anchor right now belongs to the U.S. And in more ways than one, not just because of the $25 trillion and counting debt that they have, but of, you know, again, you know, over, I want to say a third of the workforce is out of work. And you know, all the economic challenges that we're now facing, you know, whether it's oil tankers on the coast, whether it's parking lots, you know, with the stadiums full of parked cars, you know, rental cars or new cars or so, you know, whatever, you know, we're seeing a lot of disaster, you know, literally starting to spread all across the U.S. right now. And so with that being said, we need to really, really start waking up soon before it's too late. Again, you know, this whole thing was planned. This was a plandemic, okay? The world economy was already gonna come to a stop. Everything that's happening economy-wise was already planned, and they just needed an excuse, and that's why they brought this thing out, okay? This virus situation, all right? On top of that, yeah, sure, they wanted to microchip everybody, take control of everybody, and so on and so forth. You know, again, turned this into COVID-1984, but, you know, that was just kind of like extra icing on the cake. Basically, what they were just trying to do more than anything else is just, hey, we need to, you know, change from one monetary system to the next, and how are we gonna do this? We need to put everything, you know, we gotta bring everything to the stop so we can start the other one. You know, they tried to do a smooth transition, wasn't gonna happen. Things like Bitcoin and other things out there, you know, were just, you know, the internet and so on and so forth, you know, were basically, you know, throwing a monkey wrench into that plan over and over again, okay? So, in a sense, they needed to, you know, do a hard reset. And so as they're doing this hard reset, you know, right now, I mean, as they're doing this hard reset right now, what's happening is that, you know, everyone is in quarantine. Everybody is, you know, being held, again, you know, captive in a sense. And while all this is happening, they're, you know, closing down meat plants. They're restructuring the laws of the land. They're doing so many things that are going to affect you and your loved ones for generations to come. And what do I say for generations to come? Well, basically because what's happening right now, as everything is changing, no matter where you are, but especially if you are in the US, you know, the world reserve status of the US dollar is not gonna be around for much longer. And so it's not only gonna be affecting you, but it's gonna be affecting your kids and that moving forward. Now, how's it gonna affect you? It's all gonna depend on what moves you make. That's what we talk about on this channel right here. If you set yourself up correctly, you know, meaning that, you know, you're doing things like protecting your wealth, all right? Betting against the debt, becoming your own bank. Again, how do you do these things? Again, by buying things like property and other hard assets, you know, such as, you know, precious metals, whether it's gold, silver, or brand new things like Bitcoin, okay, and all that stuff. But the point is that you need to diversify, you need to hedge your bets, okay? And for anyone out there that is not doing that, for anyone out there that's just holding dollars, betting on the government, betting on Big Brother, that's not gonna end well, okay? Because again, you know, no matter who wins, you know, in the sense of like, even if you're bet against the government, I mean, bet with the government, bet on the dollar, bet on all that, and they win, they're gonna just take that away from you. Again, if you just look at history, all right? So to bet against it is the right move because that will protect you in a sense, all right? And again, you're betting against the debt, literally. So why would you bet with debt, all right? Well, again, that's another story for another day, but in the purposes of what we're speaking of right now, don't be betting on no debt. Don't be betting on that, okay? You wanna be betting on yourself, all right? Bet on yourself more than anything else, and that's what we all need to start doing here more than anything else. And I think a lot of you guys are doing it because, you know, you guys are here all the time, educating yourself, helping educate others, sharing this content, sharing this knowledge, you know, all the time asking me how, you know, what's the best gold dealer? What's the best silver dealer? Hey, where can I get Bitcoin? How do I get Bitcoin? You know, yada, yada, yada. All right. And I'm trying to do my best out here. And, but the point is that you guys are taking it upon yourself and you guys should be, you know, giving yourselves a pat on the back for, you know, being some of the smartest individuals out there, not just for watching my content, but for taking, you know, the lead and making sure that you set yourself up and you set yourself up, your family, for generations to come. Because if you don't, then unfortunately, a lot of pain is coming. A lot of years of pain is coming. Don't take it from me, take it from Mr. Bill Gates himself, because that's what exactly what he said, all right? And that's exactly what they want. You know, they want many years of pain so that, again, the rich get richer, the poor get poorer, you know, it just becomes, you know, the gap gets wider and all that stuff. But again, guys, if you look at history, you know, at the point that we're at now, the rubber band is about to snap. All right, so it's all about preparing yourself and putting yourself in the right place for the right time, which is coming right now, any day now. All right, and yeah, and if you want more context on that, please, you know, feel free to check out the rest of my channel. I have tons of content, you know, talking more in depth about that. And if you guys want more content about these topics more in depth, let me know down below in the comments, and for sure I can cover it in future episodes. Okay. And that's why on Monday night, you know, we're gonna do Monday, Sunday night, whenever it is, you know, the whole Bitcoin halving thing is happening, and we're gonna be covering that. I'm gonna be going live about an hour or so before the whole thing happens so that I can, you know, we can talk about it, you know, we can, you know, ask, you know, you guys can ask questions, I can help answer them, and, you know, we can all learn together. I might go a little earlier, but just stay tuned. Check out the Discord below, check out the community tab on my channel, and so on and so forth. And again, I'm on Twitter, I'm on Instagram, all that stuff, you know, just check, you know, everything out so that you guys know exactly when I'll be going live. But basically, I'm gonna be going live an hour or two before. So if you're interested in all this stuff, you already know what to do. So again, right now, guys, like I was saying, you know, we're already hitting that brink, you know, where people are just saying enough is enough, all right? And there's a lot of people out there that we already know, all right, because we already knew this before the virus, okay? They were, you know, loyalists to the government, loyalists to, you know, the boot being put on their face, you know, very, very happy to comply, you know, please give me more, please give me money, please, whatever. But there's a lot of people that are not falling, you know, they're not in that camp, okay? And again, the ones that are not in that camp, you know, we all have our breaking point, whether it's no more sports or football, I mean, yeah, or hamburgers or gatherings or whatever. And yeah, I think I already said that. Where do you, okay, what else? I got some notes here. I think that's it, right? Yeah. Oh, the last thing I wanted to say, which I thought was pretty interesting. There's a little, you know, let's have a little fun here. So I'm sure you guys already heard that Mr. Elon Musk and his wife, Grimes. By the way, want to hear something hilarious? I knew exactly who Elon Musk was, and I have no idea who Grimes was. My wife, she knows all about Grimes, but she's never heard of Elon Musk. Now, she kind of knew about him, is once I told her, oh, it's a rocket guy, and oh, yeah, she knew him. But anyways, you know, it goes to show you, you know what I mean? It has nothing to do with age either. It's just, like what our interests are, okay? More than anything else. But yeah, I thought that was hilarious. But anyways, as you guys already know, they had a kid, and they named it, I don't know, some mathematical equation or what have you. And at first, everybody's laughing and just having a good old time and blah, 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 you know. Just like when celebrities name their kid Apple, whatever. Until I was surfing on Twitter yesterday, and I saw, or today, or whatever, and I saw like some article by the Washington Post, you know, again, great journalism, you know. Or the New York Times, or one of these, you know, great, wonderful, I'm being sarcastic in case no one's, so in there it was saying, it's like, oh, Elon Musk can't name his kid that mathematical equation because the laws of the state, the laws of the local state don't allow him to have that name, you know, because you have to have a name. And the minute that I read that, I was like, get the beep! Get the fuck out of here. Are you serious? In the sense of like, I wasn't talking about the law thing. I was just thinking about like, oh my God, Elon Musk is a genius. Because again, I've talked about this on my channel. If you want more context, let me know and we'll get into it. But the birth certificate that we all have, that birth certificate that basically the minute you get it, your soul is signed away to the US government. So the minute you get your birth certificate, your soul is signed away to a trust, and that trust is the US government. And henceforth, you become a piece of property. If you don't believe me, check out any single piece of paper that you have, you know, any official paper that you have. Check out your license. Your name is in all capital letters. Check out any, you know, piece of paper that you get, from the light bill to your mortgage to your bank statement. Everything is in capital letters. Notice that other things are not in capital letters. The only things that are always in capital letters are corporations. So you are, in a sense, a corporation. And how did you become a corporation? Well, when you were born and your parents unwillingly, unknowingly signed away you, your soul, your body, your straw man situation. By doing that, your straw man is created. But anyways, they basically sign your life away. But again, you want more context and all that stuff on there, we can start a conversation. But anywho, so when I read that, I was like, man, get the fuck out of here. That's why they named him that equation. That's why Elon and Grimes named him that equation. So that way, he's not valid for a birth certificate. And so therefore, his parents, meaning Elon and Grimes, would be his trust. They, and that's how it should be, by the way, your parents, by the way, how it is that, you know, your parents are your trust until you are 18, and then at that point, you become your own trust again. Okay? Which is how it should be, right? Right? Up until you're 18, your parents are the ones that, you know, you're a minor, you can't do anything unless, you know, it's what your parents' permission and all that shit, but once you're 18, once you're over 18, then all of a sudden now you are the ones that make your own decisions. But this, it's partially true and not partially true because of that whole birth certificate trust thing. That's why, you know, the government can do anything and everything and anything to you because they own you. So, with that being said, there's a way to reverse it, there's a way to fix it, there's a way to, you know, attack this, okay? But again, that's not what this episode's about and what we're talking about here. But yeah, I couldn't believe that he did that. I was like, man, get the fuck out of here, you know? So yeah, I think he found the loophole there, you know what I mean? So by naming his kid that, again, the law in California says that he can't name him that because he can't get a birth certificate. Oh, okay. Now, again, people like him in his position can do that. You try doing that, and you're probably going to get a visit from DHS. You're probably going to get your kid taken away from you before you even get to take him home. And why? Well, because, again, you are deemed unfit to be a parent by the government entity, and they know better than you because they are your trust, aren't they? So even if you have a kid, well, they get to decide what happens with that because, again, you trust them with your life, you know, meaning, you know, that's why you signed away, or they have your birth certificate, you know, the whole trust thing. no matter what. So yeah, again, it's very complicated, but it's not that complicated. But that was happening there, and I'm like, man, wow. So there's a lot of things happening. You know, the same Elon is also saying, hey, end the quarantine, end the lockdown, end all this stuff. You know, I think, in my opinion, that he might be working for them, you know what I mean? The bad guys, you know what I mean? Whatever. But, you know, he could be another Bill Gates. He could be another lizard person. He could be, you know, one of the elites, one of these. But when things like this happen, it makes me think that maybe not. Maybe they're trying to make him that, and he is trying not to be that. Like Jack Dorsey from Twitter. A lot of people hate that guy, but if you really see, again, actions speak louder than words. So forget about the whole Twitter censorship shit. Who cares? He's lost control of that. We know that he doesn't own that, but instead of becoming a Mark Zuckerberg and just being a robot for the government, he doesn't do that. He's doing things like the Cash App with things with Bitcoin, you know, and again, trying to create another Twitter that is decentralized and not allowed, that won't be ever, you know, controlled by no government or any other entity and all this other stuff. So, you know, again, if you see what he does and the things, you know, you follow him for reals, you're like, oh, wow, wait a minute. Jack is most likely on our side. And that's why I think about Elon, too, even though every once in a while, you know. But yeah, I just thought that was pretty cool. I just wanted to share that with you because I know a lot of you guys, you know, listen to me, been listening to me for a while. You know, I talk about those things and we talk about those things. And yeah, you know, I just wanted to throw that out there because I just thought it was pretty cool and pretty hilarious. And for those of you guys that don't know anything about the birth certificate and have no idea what the hell I'm talking about, well, I'm sure your ears have been perking up and you're like, what? Yeah, and this is all true, by the way, all right? It all goes down to maritime law. And again, you know, I could go on and on. But guess what, guys? Time is up. Bzzz. Yeah, my electric Apple Watch, it doesn't exist. It's invisible. That's how cool it is. Just went off. Sorry. Timer went off. I wanted to keep talking, but unfortunately, we got to end it here. All right, guys. Hey, I love you guys. You guys are the best, all right? I already gave my commercial, my ad, my plug in the middle of the episode, so you guys already caught it, so I'm going to save that from, you know, happening right now. All I'm going to say is, guys, stay safe out there. You know what I mean. Not because of that, you know, disease, but the other things, right? And yeah, guys, get ready because big change is coming. And if it's not already, you know, pretty, you know, obvious and in your face, then, well, I'm telling you, it's just coming. But yeah, major change is coming, and we can all see that. That's why we're all here watching, talking, conversing, continuing this conversation, and making the conversation even louder. All right, so that's it, guys. It's time to go. Guys, thanks again for watching. Don't forget to please like, please subscribe, please share, but more importantly than anything else, please stay awesome. All right, I love you guys, and I'll see you guys on Monday, hopefully Monday. I don't want to be doing a fucking midnight show with the fucking Bitcoin thing. I'll see you Monday. Bye.